Video.
Situation's beneficial, doing something different, got me looking stupid. The only way I'm coming back to you is if you're dreaming, lose it, prove it. If you made a promise, then keep it. Why you wanna lie and then get mad? I don't believe it. But really, I was doing just fine without you. Looking fine, sipping wine, dancing, no club couches. Baby, why you wanna lose me like you don't need me? Like I don't block you and you still try to reach me. How you figure out how to call me from the TV? You running out of chances and this time I mean it.
Yeah, I bet you miss my love all in your bed. Stressing out, pulling your hair, smelling your pillows and wishing I was there. Sliding down the shower wall, looking sad. I know it's hard to let go, I'm the best. Best you ever had and best you gon' get. If we break up, I don't wanna be friends.
When I was a kid, I used to daydream about me riding a pink car just like this. Flying in the air just like that. Okay. That was actually one of my daydreams. I am a Pisces. Okay. So I thought that song was perfect for this topic. Derek Jackson being exposed. Okay. And so this topic is going on all over. So Tasha K exposed this like 3 days ago on March the 19th. And if you look at my previous video that I made, I did a oracle prophetic consultation, something very similar to this story on March the 18th. So I made my video on March the 18th, and Tasha K exposed Derek Jackson's infidelity with his out of marriage sexual relationships on the 19th, so the very next day. Okay, so if you watch my video, if you go back and you watch my video, you'll see a lot of similarities, because Derek Jackson, he and if you watch his videos, if you watch some of his videos, he said that he just now, 2020, gave his life to Christ. So this is something recent. We're in 2021, so this was just last year. So if he just now gave his life to Christ, that would explain, if you think about it, all this stuff that's going on or has gone on with him and these relationships outside of his marriage. Okay, because when you're in a marriage, you're already supposed to be grounded in God. And so according to the videos and what they said, only one person in the marriage was grounded in God, and it was the wife, which her name is Danaya, I believe. Yeah, Danaya. Okay, and we had not seen Danaya at all. He had not posted his wife. So he's been married for 4 years. They've been together for 14 years, but he's been married for 4 years. And so he had never posted his wife until now, until recently. Okay, so we never knew what she looked like. I don't know if it was just hiding or just not wanting to put her out there, just putting himself out there or whatever, for whatever reasons. But he had not put her out there. So we didn't know what she looked like, anything. I thought it was another person. I thought his wife was another person because I seen somebody else, which was a second person, who said that he had slept with her. So I thought that was his wife, because I don't really pay attention to, I only watch a few of his videos. I had not watched a lot of his videos, or I've never really followed him as much. So I didn't really try to figure out what type of a person he is or anything like that. I did like his messages. A lot of his messages were good and correct. It seemed like, according to all the stuff that's happening now, it seemed like he was not following his information. He was putting out good information, but he was not following it. So now we got all this craziness. And today I heard that it was on the radio. So not only is it all over social media, YouTube, all that, but the radio has is now picking up all the information up too, because people know Derrick Jackson. He's well known. Person who puts out positive messages about relationships and all that, and he's supposed to be married and all that, but now it's out here saying that he has been with other women, even though he's married. So let's go ahead and, you know, get into it. We're gonna dive a little bit deep. I'm not trying to make this video very long, because I'm just trying to, you know, keep it short or whatever. But this topic goes along with pretty much all the stuff that I have been talking about on my channel. I also wanted to talk about this because it's about divine partnerships, or, you know, some people say kingdom marriages. And that's another thing that they use. So Derrick Jackson, he just said that he gave his life to God. He gave his life to Christ, even though you're supposed to already give your life to God before you get married, both be grounded into it. So this is another reason why this relationship is on very rocky grounds, because only one person was grounded into God, which was Danaya, the wife, and he was not. Okay, and if you watch my video that I made before, the information is very similar. So they were talking about kingdom marriages, now he gave himself to God and all that. And my video that I made on March the 18th, the day before Tasha K exposed this one, which was the 19th, after I made my video, talked about a masculine, a divine masculine. So if he called himself a kingdom man for God and all that, then that will go along with my video that I made the day before. Okay, so if he's apparently is a part of the kingdom, the divine marriages, the divine unions, the kingdom marriages, whatever, you know, God's holy kingdom, then you will see a lot of similarities of what I had already said on my prophetic oracle consultation that I do. And I actually get all my information from the Most High, from God. I used cards before, because I know that you seeing cards, and a lot of people like to come and watch that or whatever. But now I have been called and led to, because I get all the information anyway without cards. So it's really no sense for me to use cards when I already have all the information. So I've always have all the information. So all my videos that I've made, always, and you see my videos and people all say, oh, you gave me help and you helped save me from all type of craziness and things like that. I got all the information from God, from high divine, most high source, God, okay? So, and I had it all before even the cards, okay? So, and as you see in the last video that I made, I had all the information, and now this divine union, or this supposedly divine union, they're calling themselves divine union now that Derek Jackson has is newly into this God thing here, because he just gave his life to Christ last year, so he's still on this journey of trying to be better and better himself, even though he has made several videos for years talking about good relationships and stuff. Okay, so it seemed like to me he should have already been gave his life to Christ and God or whatever, and be on this process giving out people good messages of holy unions and good unions or whatever. But that's just what a lot of people would already, you know, think already. But apparently he's doing it backwards, but now his relationship on shaky and rocky grounds because of it. So that's just something that you might want to think about in your relationships, in your unions, your marriages, and all that, is you need to be grounded in God. Man, woman, and God, okay? God should be in the middle. God should be grounded. God should be there before any unions, before especially marriages, okay? You don't just be on shaky, rocky grounds and all that. You have to have God the Most High in that union, or you will have craziness like this, like what's going on with Derek Jackson here. Okay, and so if you watch my previous video, it talked about a masculine who was an emperor type, and they were living good. I said they were living good. It was kind of like luxury, which he's living good, living luxury and all that. But it was like he wanted to go out and party, and something happened to where he died, so something ended. So it goes along with that, goes along with exactly what I was saying, something about something ended, died, whatever. And he had kids, and I said this, I think this person has kids, or a child or kids. I said that, and Derek Jackson has kids, okay, because we got to talk about divine unions, divine marriages. So this is going along with all of our divine unions, all our divine marriages here, okay? This is just something that God wanted to put information out here to, as a collective, to help, okay? And so, and then something happened and something ended. And then, you know, I said the woman was very sad, and he saw that. And so if he's a part of this divine union and God and being newly with God and all that, like he said, then according to my prophetic message, he is kind of sorry, even though according to my prophetic message, he still wants to go out and still do those partying or whatever he was doing. That's what I got before in my prophetic message. He still wants, but he is, according to mine, it says that he was, but since he's seen how sad and all that and all pain and whatever it caused, then he is kind of feeling other type of way or whatever too as well. So according to my prophetic message, he has been doing those going out, partying, doing things that he's not supposed to, even though he is emperor or high vibration or emperor, is like he's both. But he's more of high, but he's also got that low in him too, as well, according to what I got, the message I got before even all this came out. And as you, if you look at him, you will see that as well, because he was able to put out information, all that stuff, and everything. And, you know, he is what he's created for himself. So everything that I said is aligning with this story here. Okay. So, if you want to watch that, you can watch it, but I wanted to, you know, put that information out there, because that's the information that I got even before this story, so you can maybe get a better or clearer picture of what's going on, because I watched a few videos. I watched his videos he put out. I watched some videos that other people put out, Tasha K and some other people. A lot of people was not falling for any of the stuff that he was saying. A few people was like, okay, you're trying to renew yourself with God and all that. It's good. And, you know, Jesus Christ, because I do believe in God and I do believe in Jesus Christ, rose from the dead, because, you know, I'm an old soul. Okay. And one of the main things that people was trying to do in ancient times, pyramids and all that, is try to figure out how to raise up to higher heaven realm. That was really the main thing. And the thing is, people found out it was hard. They were trying to figure it out because as human beings, we are not always perfect. Even if you have a pure heart like myself, or, you know, you're naturally good, like, you know, high vibration people are, it's still hard in, you know, especially in this world, especially today when we've got all this craziness, darkness and craziness going on. And just thinking a lot of things is topsy-turvy and everything. It can be really difficult, okay, for a lot of people. And if it's difficult for, you know, pure hearts and good people, and you work really hard, and you know you can't always be perfect unless you are a baby or something, okay? But you can't always be perfect. So that is what the ancients, pyramids, they were trying to figure out. How can we do this? Because you can try to be as perfect or good as you possibly can and still not make it, not raise up to the higher realms, higher heaven realms. And so that is what Jesus Christ was for. Or some people call him Yeshua, some people call him, you know, different names, but that's what Jesus Christ was for. Jesus Christ came in, he was prophesied to come or whatever. And so that helped bridge the gap of perfection, to help us raise up. Because the thing is, we get to live, okay? So Jesus Christ was like 100% human and also 100% God. Us, because we want to live, you know, marriage, kids, Derek Jackson, them, and divine kingdom marriages and unions and things like that, have relations, be intimate, go out, have a little fun. Some people want to have more fun than others. You can't always be perfect when you're living life and you're enjoying and all that. We want to live. So we're not going to be 100% God or 100% and 100% human at the same time like Jesus. So it's like Jesus sacrificed his life. Jesus sacrificed living. That's what it is. He sacrificed living so we could live. Because even if someone like me, a pure heart, because everybody knows we're children of God, like, so we're like God's essence and we're of God and we're like God, but we're like children of God because we are not 100% God, because we want to live. That's the difference. He did not live like we do. Like, we want to experience. God wants to experience things. So God gets to experience it through us. And so Jesus Christ, him sacrificing himself, not experiencing everything like we can, him doing that is like super amazing. It's like show nothing but love, gratitude, all that. He did that. He put himself up to do that, which, because he so loved the world. So he so loved us. He so loved, you know, the divine feminine. He so loved all of us, everybody. You know, all the beings of good and light. He so loved us, okay? The God so loved us, okay? And so that is his that was his purpose, and that's what he does. Because there's another thing is, what's that movie? Aladdin. If you watch Aladdin with Will Smith, you'll know the one who has all power has to do all this work. We don't want to always have to do the work. We want to live and have some fun and be a child of God, because everybody knows if you have a good parents or whatever, who's really having a good time? It's gonna be the kids. They don't gotta work. All they have to do is come home. Food is being prepared. Things is being prepared. You get your clothes. Oh, I want this, mommy. I want this, daddy. You come home to your night. Everything's already done, prepared for you. Who you wanna be? You wanna be a child of God. You wanna be somebody whose things is being prepared for and all that. So we get to be children of God. So things is being taken care of for us, prepared. I mean, obviously we have to do work and we have to do what we're supposed to do and do our learning and just all this. But still, we don't want to have to be doing all the work. So that's why you'll see the divine feminine will sit back and chill and be a child of God or whatever instead of doing all the work. Okay, so if you see what Revelations, Revelations 21:1-17. Okay, if you check that out. Okay, so it's Revelations 12:1-17. So if you check that verse out, you will see where it says, you know, a divine feminines, and Jesus Christ, and then all the rest of the children of God, and then you have the devil or whatever, the dragon trying to go after divine feminines and Jesus Christ and the children of God, and you know, and cause problems and all that type of stuff. So you can check that verse out there, okay? But this goes into what this whole thing with the Derrick Jackson and his extramarital affairs that he was in, because he was still married. That's why it's very important that if you have a guy and he's saying, oh, he's separated from his spouse, his wife or whatever, that you make sure before you do any whatever or get serious or anything like that, that you have divorce papers for this reason here. And so this is a learning lesson for a lot of people, for everybody, and for a lot of people out there, because who knows how many people he was with, because he had known this one person, the main person that everybody talked about, which is a girl named Candace. She went on Tasha K and exposed everything, because she had known him, and they were had been talking and, you know, talking and everything for like 10 years, but they had not did anything until recently. And so anything intimate until recently, okay? And so, and then as soon as he, you know, brought her to his house while the wife was gone somewhere out of the whatever city or whatever, she was around taking pictures and just thinking that they were going to be together or whatever, because they had been known each other for 10 years. But then something happened, who knows, whatever, he got back with his wife and he blocked her on everything. And so that's why she had to go on to Tasha K and expose everything, because she didn't know what was going on. She was confused because she had been talking to him for 10 years and in her mind he was separated, and then all of a sudden now he blocked her on everything. And but now there's other people that's coming up, and there's a second person that came up who said that she was with him in his condo. So he had a condo as well. Why did he have a condo? People were saying to bring females there, I don't know, but he had a condo and he brought her there. And the second person, I don't know her name, I didn't get her name or whatever, but I know I seen her picture on his on timeline, on social media timeline, and I thought that was what his wife looked like, because he never posted his wife. So he would post pictures of himself looking like a model, you know, model pics and all that, you know, females could get lured in by that, who knows or whatever. But then when we finally saw his wife, we finally saw her on some video, on a couple of videos that he just now put out. Okay, people were saying, oh, they had to get their lie together. People were saying, oh, they had to rehearse what they was gonna say. He had to save this image. Who knows? Who are, hey, okay. But according to my prophetic message, I got that because of her sadness, and he did feel some type of way. He was starting to change. He was, so she said that he was changing. She said that the only reason why she took him, taking him back, Danaya, his wife, is because he changed. Now, if he is a part of the kingdom marriage, according to the prophetic message that I got, he is changing or has changed because of the hurt that he's seen he had done to her. Okay. And so, but I also, what I've seen from the videos that he put out, because he put a couple videos out explaining everything, his first video where he was talking about Candace, this is the first one, and it seemed like he really liked this person. He brought her to the house. He didn't bring her to the condo. He brought her to his actual house, okay, in his wife's bed, in his wife's bed while she was gone, while his wife was gone, okay, in his wife's house, in her bed. So, I mean, you have to look at all this here. This, I was like, oh, I just felt so bad for his wife. And people was like, oh, people, I mean, this, that whole thing was embarrassing, very embarrassing. And the way, on the second one where, well, on the videos where he was him and his wife talking, she had a bonnet, people were talking about her because she had a bonnet on. I started to put my bonnet on here, you know what I'm saying? I was like, man, should I put my bonnet on, you know? Okay, so, but I was embarrassed for her because how he talked about her in his first video that he said, how he talked about his wife, about how she wasn't pleasing him. Lord, okay. She said, he said, he telling the whole world this. It's like he was giving out a secret message or a code to women or some. My wife is not pleasing me. I was embarrassed for his wife. Okay, when I was listening, I was like, "Is this how you talk about your wife, who you're supposed to love here?" That's why I'm like, if he is actually a part of the kingdom, and not a false, then he is. Sorry, but then how he was talking about his wife, and I was like, come on now, you don't, even if you're angry or whatever, you don't say negative stuff about your wife or the mother of your children. I don't know how many children they got, okay? And my prophetic message I got, I saw that he had at least, somebody had at least one, you know, one or a few or whatever. So I don't know how many children they have together, but, you know, they're supposedly back together. They're working on their marriage and all that. It's because of God and him actually changing. She said she's seen a change in him. And if he is a part of the kingdom marriage, then according to my prophetic message, there is possibly a change, even though he still wants to do some partying out there. Okay, because that's what I got. He still wanted to do some of that. But because of the hurt and pain, he has made some changes because if he is a part of that, he does love his wife. But what I saw on the video and how he was talking about her, it did not seem like he was all in love like that with her, you know. But you know, she had, and then when I seen that video of him and her, they were holding hands like they were had this rehearsed speech going on, holding hands all tight, and people were talking about how he was holding hands, it was forced, and she was being held hostage and all that. And I was like, goodness gracious. And you know, her looking plain and then having that bun on her head. And then I watched a few of her things. She said she don't care how she looked, she's here for God and a message and all that, and I have no problem with that. She had her hat on, her was not done. And you know, if she put out, I do agree with, you know, God and putting out good messages and family and unions and divine unions and marriages and things like that, and helping the world and being a light into the world. I totally agree with that. Okay. But, and I also don't like the fact that he was doing all this out, you know, these relationships outside of this thing, this marriage here. And what would explain it is because he was just now getting saved by God last year. So, and you're supposed to be already deeply rooted in God before anything, and they're just not doing that. So we got a lot of stuff going on here in this whole craziness. Okay, so I had already made videos about some Karma females, okay? So a lot of people had got exposed by karma females. I call these people karma females. Karma females is something happened to them, hurt, pain, or whatever, and all of a sudden it's like their energy, they've been called by God to bring down low vibration men, or men that's put themselves high, and but they really have low vibration in them. So he had been T.I. already got exposed, but now he had got exposed here by karma females. And I heard I already made an oracle prophetic message about karma females here already. I already posted it on my social medias, and I also made a video about it. So this stuff is revealing itself, okay? So the karma females got him. If I was him, I would not, because of everything that has gone out now, you got a lot of people that's gonna be watching and seeing, and karma females is gonna be looking and learn themselves too. So if I was him, I would be careful even more, okay, with the karma females and with females. And he need to be on the straight and narrow, getting himself right. That is just a big suggestion that I got for him, okay. But I wanted to go into real quick about divine unions. So, because I know some people, they're waiting on trying to find a divine union, and they're trying to heal themselves, get themselves together. And I wanted to let you know that we can only do so much by ourselves. We can heal ourselves to a certain point. We can maybe heal ourselves to maybe 60, 70, with a lot of heart rate, maybe 80, you know, a good passing grade, 70 or whatever percent. We can do that on our own. So you're not going to be totally healed. But when you get with your right person, flesh of my flesh, bone of my bone, then that's when your full energy will be emerged, and your love and all that, and protection and all that, and your oneness will be put together, okay? But you can do so much by yourself, but then when you're with your right person, that is what happens. And so I wanted to just put that out there for some of you guys, because I know some people, they try to work on themselves. And but like, I mean, I got to try to be, you know, almost 100%, and you're not going to be 100%. You're not going to be all way up there. But with your right person, you will be way up there. Okay. You'll be fully up there. Okay. But you will always have to, even with your divine unions and your marriages, you will always have to work on yourself. Heal and all that. And it's a process, but you will be good, and you'll be able to do your divine partnerships and your unions and your missions and all that together, healing. And but you have to do this in God, with God in the midst of it, okay? So I wanted to, you know, put that information out there for you guys, because this whole thing will line up with everything that I've always, you know, always said. And you know, I just wanted to help you guys out real quick, make this short video, so about 32 minutes, 33 minutes, or whatever. So I'm gonna go ahead and leave it there. If you want any all natural products, click on the link below. If you want any consultation services or anything, the link is below. And also, you can donate as well. Peace and love to you guys. Mwah.